Peter, give me a geography lesson. What is special about fruit and this part of the world?
We can grow just about any piece of fruit in the world in Shepparton. Apart from the natural resource of irrigation and the water we have from that and our soil types, we can grow stone fruit, apples and pears, and we can even grow pomegranates in this area. So it's quite unique in the world. There's not too many places that you could actually grow all of those varieties of fruit in the one place.
Last time I was here, an old bloke met out in a paddock told me, you could grow anything here, son, even clergymen, if you could get the seed.
Now, correct. In a sense, he's right. We basically think we can just about do any fruit other than tropical fruit that's grown in the world in the Shepparton region.
I'm interested in your pomegranates, because when I was a kid growing up in Launceston, lots of old gardens had a pomegranate tree,
yeah.
But we didn't know what it was for. We used to, believe it or not, throw them at one another.
Yeah. That's a common story. When we started growing pomegranates in Shepparton nearly 10 years ago, the first comment people would make would be, oh, I remember pomegranates. As a kid, we used to chuck them at each other and we'd get covered in
red
stain. Yeah.
It was an early form of paintball.
Yeah, just about, actually. We basically got introduced to the product by someone who was wanting to invest in this region. And we took a trip to Israel, really the home of pomegranates.
Yes.
It's almost a revered fruit.
Thousands of years ago.
Yeah, all the history.
Yeah.
So we went over there and we looked at the product. I'd actually never even eaten a pomegranate before. We looked at the technology, and there was some new technology invented that extracted the seeds from the pomegranate. And then we came back to Australia and we tossed around the idea of maybe setting up an investment property in Shepparton. We did that in 2008. We had some other investors come in the journey with us. For us, it's been a really exciting adventure.
Explain to me the anatomy of a pomegranate and what it is that you're actually extracting.
Inside the pomegranate is some juice-filled little sacs. We call them arils.
Yeah.
Some people call them the seeds of the pomegranate.
Yeah.
But actually, inside those little sacs of juice is a tiny little seed as well. So it does get
a little crunchy.
It's a little bit crunchy. We take them out of the fruit because it just puts it in a convenient form. I often say to people, a pomegranate isn't the sort of fruit you toss in the back seat to your kids
no.
have a feed. You'd soon find it all over the place.
Yeah.
So what we do is we take the seeds out, or the arils out. We put them in a punnet for consumers to buy in Coles and Woolworths.
Do you cook with it?
Yeah, my wife does. It's very versatile. One of the best ways to eat pomegranates is in the frozen form. It almost eats like ice cream.
In trendy restaurants, particularly hipster places, everybody is drinking the juice.
We actually produce a juice in a partnership with another local crowd that juices it for us. There's even people talking about getting powdered pomegranate to use as a sprinkle on whatever they're going to cook up. So there is quite a variety of different products you can make from pomegranates.
You have a physics background, don't you?
Yeah, long time ago.
Yeah, but you're a man of science. Do you believe the health claims that are made for pomegranate juice?
I've been in the fruit game a long time, and we've heard all sorts of claims.
All kinds of wonderful.
This is going to put 20 years on your life and cure all manner of diseases. So we looked into the claims. I think pomegranates are one of the few superfoods that does have some science that backs up its claim for having health properties. That sort of free radical attack,
right,
that people often claim about their fruit. So I think it does actually stack up.
What's your feeling about the argument about genetic modification? Gene sharing, etc. Frankenstein fruit.
I probably don't have any opposition to the idea of producing a fruit through genetic means, but I think it needs to be tested thoroughly. That's probably how I'd view it.
Speaking of Shepparton, what is special about this place? I mean, everyone has a passion, don't they?
I've lived in Shep all my life. I went to uni for a few years, but came back to work on the farm. Look, I think the people really is what drive the passion. I mean, I've got lifelong friends that I went to kindergarten with, primary school with, high school with. I still knock around today with them and I see them. So there's a certain love for the community that I think people from Shepparton have. I think that generates a certain passion. I mean, I care for the people of Shepparton. They're all my friends. I can walk down the street to Shepparton and I know people immediately. I've just seen them for, you know, the 50-odd years of my life. So I think that engenders a certain passion for the sort of community that we're in. The other thing I think that drives our passion is we do something really special. I mean, growing natural food, you know, I went out this morning, the pickers are out there picking the fruit. I'm looking at the trees that we've been growing now for 30 or 40 years. I mean, there's a certain excitement about that. Sure. There's a certain wonder about the fact that in Shepparton, we've got our soil, we've got our water, we've got our people, we've got these fruit trees, and we produce this fantastic food that I know when people come, just like you've probably come to Shepparton and you've grabbed an apple off a tree, they eat it and they say, wow, yeah, this is fantastic.
Yeah, why can't I get that in the supermarket?
Why can't I get that somewhere else,
yeah,
you know?
Exactly.
I mean, to me, that gives me a bit of passion for what I do, because I think, gee, we're doing something pretty wonderful, I reckon, in Shepparton.
I can understand the passion for the food and the wine, and I've caught that. I met a bloke who was passionate about concrete pipes.
Why not?
Takes all kinds of Shepparton.
And again, we've been a tremendous receiver of refugees, immigrants, people from all over the world.
40-odd nations.
And we do a fantastic job of saying to anyone, you know what? Come along, no matter how you are, no matter where you are in life, no matter what you've done, and have a new start here. Have a new crack at life. What that does is it produces a situation where people come with their own ideas. I don't know about the concrete pipe guy, but why not?
They bring a fruit we've never seen before.
Bring a fruit we've never seen before. Make some concrete pipes. Do something else that no one's done. And they actually bring that to Shepparton.
Great place.
It is a great place.
Good on you.